You see, several days ago, I bought what I thought was a super clean 1968 Ford Galaxie XL. How about 11?
Cool.
Good deal.
Hey, do we get a chance to buy it back? What are you gonna do with it?
I wanna give these guys the courtesy of having the first look, and the other day they reached out, said they were gonna be coming through Dallas, asked if they could stop by, and I said, sure, come on by. It's good to have interest this early, but we have even more pressure to get it done on time. I gave the monkey 7 days and $6,000 to clean it, lower it, and repaint it. That's it, should have been easy. But as soon as we got it into the garage, the monkey started poking around and found heavy rust in the rockers and the quarter panels.
Does it ever stop?
And scaling on the chassis.
It's not looking good.
They decided to go against my build request to keep it simple and decided to take the whole damn thing apart. Why did we do all this?
The large gaping rust holes in the quarter panels.
Shit. Amazingly, they were able to repair the rust damage and repaint the car in record time. But unfortunately for them, I mean Mike Coy, when he showed me the paint job, I hated it. It's got more orange peel and waves in it. You can't even see the reflection here. The reflection moves. Here's what I think. Put it back over there, take it back apart, whatever you gotta do, refix it. Work all night if you have to. I want it right. And I'm not giving you any more days, so you better get busy.
All right, let's strip it.
Yeah.
Honestly, Richard's problem with the paint is pretty legit. We only had time to block sand it once, which didn't fully even out the surface. So when you look at the paint, it reflects the little waves and imperfections and lacks that awesome mirror finish. So this time we're gonna do it right. We're gonna strip the car back down and block it two more times between the layers of primer, and then apply the final prime and paint. It'll take over 16 hours, so we're working through the night. And if it all goes well, we'll finish around dawn with a smooth, glossy Galaxie XL.
Looks good to me.
Well, I can see your reflection is damn good, yeah.
I see nothing wrong with it.
Other than the reflection of your face, that's about it.
Perfect. We still gotta buff the deck lid, but we can do it in the morning.
We're just finishing up on it. If you are good with it, we will get it shipped over there. And
it looks just as good, if not better.
This is a great car. Russell, come on. I mean, I had Mike Coy freaking out, thinking he was gonna have to paint it again, but like a true New Yorker, Russell opened his loud mouth, and now everybody knows what I was planning. 10 times better. See what happens when you take the time to do it right?
We're doing it fast because you keep telling us to do it fast.
Yeah.
Speed makes money.
No, I get it. But it also makes less than awesome paint jobs that you send back and have redone.
It really looks good.
It looks great.
All right, let's get it over the other side, get it on the frame. And we only got 3 days left.
If we get it done before your time frame, can we have a couple days off?
If you don't get it done in my time frame, you can have a lot of days off.
All right. Looks great.
We'll get it cleaned up and get it over there.
Yep.
Hell yeah, bunch of days off.
We got just 3 days left on the Galaxie, and there's still a ton of work left to be done.
All right.
We should have that chassis back today. I may go ahead and replace the oil pan too, because it's looking pretty rough. While the Galaxie chassis is out for powder coating, I'm giving the motor a quick once over. That means cleaning it up, and after Mike paints it the proper Ford blue, I'll replace the damaged oil pan and button it up with all new gaskets and seals.
A lot of grime.
They'll be almost anywhere there's metal on metal. And their function is crucial to providing an airtight seal to avoid leaks of liquids and gases.
There you go.
That's what a 335 horsepower 428 V8 should look like. Nice and new.
Damn, those are sick.
You remember how to do this?
I remember. But if we don't get the Galaxie done in time, Richard's not gonna let us go jump with the Golden Knights.
Boop.
I can't wait to get them mounted up and get them on the car. I think they're gonna look really good.
I gotta tell you, the paint crew is really taking a beating, working all night to get the paint just right. But we're part of the big Gas Monkey team here and ready to do whatever it takes to get this build done on time. I say we get the body over here, get it on the lift, and then we'll roll the chassis underneath it. We got the car over to the mechanic side, and we're getting it ready to put it on the chassis.
Looks great from here. You happy with it?
Just happy with it the first time.
I hear you. Me too. I thought it looked great too.
You gotta come down and touch for me.
Okay. You ready?
Okay. Good.
You sure about this?
Yeah. That'll hold.
If it falls off the lift, it'll just be par for the course.
little more, right there. Bring her down. Dude, this is a good major next step.
Hell yeah, I'm excited for it.
All right, what do we got besides a beautiful paint job?
Want to push it back?
Looks good.
Oh, man. Dude.
Woo! Sounds like out of time.
Try it again.
The wires could be in the wrong order.
That could be.
Yeah, one's right here right now, but I think it should be right there.
Yeah, we're one off all the way around.
Okay, here we go.
Trying to start it up. This thing ran like a top when we got brought it in here.
Did it?
Yeah.
Tops don't really run either, they just spin.
So what analogy would you make?
Runs like Richard's exes.
Ready? Ready?
Yeah.
Come on, baby.
Apparently that wasn't it.
You know, it ran and drove when I brought it in.
It just needs a tickle in the right spot.
Mm-hmm.
It smells like a lot of gasoline.
Yeah, Mike flooded it.
Mike spilled it.
Just stare at it for a minute, it'll work. Normally, I don't hover over the guys when they're trying to get things done, but Ben and Dino are coming by tomorrow, and so I'm gonna do a little helicopter parenting. I like it. Paint's looking good. Be way cooler if it ran. Choke it!
Oh. All right.
Yeah, somebody put that distributor in backwards?
No, we never took it out.
I took it out. I don't know which car he's talking about, but yes.
Okay, I might have put the distributor back in wrong. It's a rookie mistake, but one with a super easy fix. I just pull the distributor, rotate the bottom gear 180 degrees, put it back in, and we should be good. We're ready to start the car.
It's not gonna run with the cap off.
Well, I know. You have any faith in me?
I got faith.
Okay. Tony and I have a lot of faith.
Can
you
start it?
It's all you, brother.
Go ahead.
Come on.
It's all right.
Oh, hey. Okay, even a broken clock is right twice a day.
Hey, did we get anything for that?
Yeah, you get to finish the job.
Yeah. It does sound good.
That's all we
100%.
You guys got this? Button
yep.
it up? Okay,
yep.
I'm gonna go finish my other project.
Yep.
Mike painted the bumpers to match the body. Losing the chrome gives the car a smooth, clean look.
Look, we just put this on there and we're done.
The chrome tips will dress up the exhaust.
Done and done.
It's a small but important detail.
And then this just sits on top?
Yeah, it's just which way does it go?
Not that way. Look at the angle of the trunk. There you go. Angle of the trim, angle of the trunk. Love it. I think it's money. We had some nuts. You don't have the nuts to finish the job? All right, that's the last one.
Awesome.
And lastly, Russell and Mike are buttoning up the tailplate. Then our star will be about ready to shine.
It's gonna totally finish it off.
Yeah, looks pretty good.
Killed it.
Let's get out of here.
Here it is, our 1968 Ford Galaxie XL. And what it looks like today is a far cry from when Richard brought it back from Minnesota.
Oh yeah!
Frankly, it wasn't looking that bad until we started to poke at it.
Oh man.
Turns out it was a rust bucket. We deconstructed the car so the monkeys could repair the rust holes, powder coat the chassis, and clean decades of crud off the underbelly.
Coal miner-esque.
I made Richard happy by coming up with a color that honored the original factory paint, but with a little extra snap. What didn't make him happy were the imperfections that he saw because he didn't give us enough time.
Take it back apart, whatever you gotta do, fix it.
But after the second trip through the paint shop, it sparkles like, you guessed it, a diamond in a goat's ass.
Under the hood, we revamped the original 428 powertrain so it looks better than showroom ready. There you have it. Us monkeys made Richard's deadline. Now it's up to him to make that first right of refusal pay off with the original owners.